Okay, so it's nearly school holidays right across Australia, but many parents and carers are already wondering how the hell we're going to keep our cooped up kids on track with their school, especially if this thing drags on for months.
I would say to everyone, just be kind to themselves, lower your expectations, just giving your kids some time to relax. No one can learn anyway if they're stressed.
But many families are dealing with sudden unemployment and uncertainty. Some homes don't have the internet or enough devices. Take on schooling as well. It's a lot.
Parents are not expected to replace teachers. We'll still be there. We'll be moving online and guiding you and your children in this learning. Don't forget that learning is involved in so many everyday activities. So cooking with your children, you know, drawing a bird's eye view, map of the house, all those things, don't feel like it needs to look how it might look at school. We're doing things differently.
Education departments across Australia are ramping up online learning. In Queensland, students from prep through to high school can access 2-week units of work across a range of subjects.
With teenagers, it's really about sitting down with them beforehand and looking at what does their day look like, what do they need to learn, where are the points where they know they really need some social connection or a little hit of positivity, getting them to plan their day. It's the old expression, control the controllables, and forewarned is forearmed.
And while public schools are moving online, the private sector's already made the switch. This was Haileybury High School in full swing in Melbourne last week.
So if I can get you to focus on one of those things, practice test needs to be first.
So kids, help your parents out. They are just trying to make sure you are set up for the future. And us parents will try and understand that the thing you really are missing most is your mates.
So much of school is not just the academic learning, but it's the social needs that are met for our kids and our emotional needs. And so it's really important for us as parents right now to be thinking, how can I boost a sense of positive emotions into my kids' life and make sure that our kids are getting their social needs met?
Already heaps of you are using Zoom or House Party to make sure you can still see your pals. But for now, you just can't hang with them IRL.
At the moment, it's going to have to be through social media, Insta, Snapchat, gaming and so on.
We're in a time where everything we knew has suddenly changed. But if we stick together, well, 1.5 metres apart, move our hangs online and wash our hands properly, then hopefully we'll be back to normal life sooner. And that means back to school.
Some days will be better than others, and that's okay. And really try to celebrate those little wins. If you manage to play a board game together and have some great family time, if you manage to read some books together and get some of your own work done, that's a win.
Everyone's on a bit of an emotional roller coaster right now. Things are moving at breakneck speed. I think we just have to be mindful of the fact that this is a huge transition. It's just a matter of having patience and giving ourselves all permission to be human.
It's so weird at the moment. I feel like parenting at the moment is like doing life without all the scaffolding that makes it possible to be a good parent. You know, yeah. You've taken away school, the weekly activities, the contact with friends, playgrounds are shut. You know, there's not the support network you had to maybe give you those breaks during the week. And I feel like it's so incredibly challenging, even though within that there are beautiful moments that you wouldn't otherwise have had, but we're having because of this. But just hearing that we're not expected to replace 7 hours of school at home, I think is a major relief. The thoughts that they're going to pick up education in other ways with us, and maybe the time we're spending them, that valuable time, will enrich them in ways that when they go to school they don't have that. So just seeing those, seeing the positives, not just focusing on the load.
Here's a question for you three parents. I mean, isn't the hardest thing that you don't know when this is going to end? I mean, this could go on for 6 months, 8 months, 3 months, doesn't matter. I mean, that must be really difficult. You've all got a plan to protect your children at home and teach them, but you don't know when it's going to finish.
Mate, we were feeling positive after that. Don't bring the mood down.
How can you feel positive when you don't know when it's going to finish?
No, but you know what I would say? I actually think the length of time doesn't make as much difference as you might think, Steve. Like, I've just assumed it's going to be a long time. It could be 3 months.
And if it's less, great.
Yeah, it doesn't actually change what you need to do that much. Like, and schools will get better at it as well, right? There are schools right now just trying to figure out how they deliver all this
sort of
stuff.
It'd be interesting for people at higher end of school.
Well, year 12s, I think, is a big thing. But I've got my kids in the painting. They've got 2 bedrooms to go. So
excellent.
I thought you meant Picasso style. Yeah. Sure.